in every industry, there's always jargon or a certain language that the people in that industry speak. And unless you work in that industry, you have no idea what these people are talking about. So in this video, we're gonna go back to the basics. I just wanna cover the different parts of the roof and what they're called. So I'm gonna start with the most basic term that you actually might have heard before, but this whole section here from this corner all the way down there, that is called a slope. Some people call them facets, but in this video, we'll call it a slope. And a slope is measured by pitch. You can see this would actually be a very steep roof in real life, but you may hear your roofers talk about, oh, that's a 9-12 pitch, 10-12 pitch, that's an 18-12 pitch, which would be closer to what this is. But that describes the steepness of it. The higher the number, the steeper the roof is. Now down here, this leading edge actually has a name. This is called your eave. This is the horizontal edge of the roof. And this is where you'll have drip edge installed, starter strip, and this is where the roofers actually start the shingling process. Now the sloped part, or the pitched part of the edge of the roof, is called your rake, or your rake edge. Again, you can have drip edge and starter strip here. For the sake of this, we don't have drip edge, but on any home that we build, we actually do put drip edge on all the eaves and rakes. But when you have two rakes that meet, they form this big triangle. This is called a gable. So if you ever hear someone say, oh, you've got gable vents. If you look at the big triangle on the side of your house, you'll see a vent up here. That is a gable vent on the side of your gable. Now, your eaves are made up of a couple different things. First of all, you usually have a rafter tail in here, and that's where the actual framing inside of this, which I'll show you in a minute, it ends. This is called your tail, where it overhangs the part of the house, and you have fascia and soffit. Fascia is what these gutters, what's right behind these gutters themselves. Now let's come in here. Now roof slopes meet in primarily two different ways. In this case, we have two slopes that are meeting in a valley. There's a lot of different ways to do valleys. You have woven valleys, you have no cut valleys. This is what's called an open valley with copper W-shaped flashing in it. The reason why this is called a W-shaped flashing is because it actually looks like a W. Pretty neat. Now, when we come up to the top here, where two slopes meet at a peak, that's actually called your ridge. This black stuff you see right here, this is actually called ridge vent. And these shingles that are installed on top of the ridge vent are called ridge cap shingles. Now let me take you to the other side and show you what the opposite of a valley is. Now, if you notice, these two slopes, just like the other side, are joining, but instead of joining in, they join out. This is what we call a hip. So you'll notice, as opposed to having metal or shingles woven together, these actually just meet, and then we put more ridge cap shingles over them. So this is what forms your ridge cap. So now that we've covered like the basic terminology of the different parts of your roof, I want to tell you something really important. You're going to hear your roofer say, oh, your roof is 19 squares. And that's just our way of measuring the size. A square, if you take one square and multiply it by 100, that gives you the square footage. So a 19 square roof is actually 1900 square feet. That's just more roofer jargon, and you're going to hear it if you're shopping for a new roof. But what I want to do right now is actually go inside of this thing, because I've got a little mock attic in here. And I want to show you those rafters I was talking about, because they're very important. So let's crawl in here. Are you still? Okay, so now we're in this really small kind of fake attic that we have here. But I want to show you some really key things that you're probably going to hear your roofer talk about. So I said rafter earlier. This is actually a rafter. This is the structure behind the actual roof. This is what holds everything up. Now down here, if you go down here, this part that goes past this plate here, the rafter that extends down here is called the rafter tail. So I said that earlier, that is a rafter tail. Now this part right here that the shingles are actually nailed into, right here, it's OSB sheathing. We call this sheathing or roof decking. So when you hear someone talk about rotten decking, this is what we're talking about. This is what we're talking about that's rotten. This is what's holding, or what all the shingles are actually nailed into. Right here, this kind of simulates a stud wall. Like this is the outside wall of your house that all that hardy siding, in the case of our showroom, is nailed to. So this is a 2x4 stud with sheathing, and usually on the outside of this sheathing, you're gonna have some type of moisture barrier, like a house wrap, Tyvek house wrap or something like that. Okay. All right, so now that we're out of that really tight attic, I wanna talk about the most common flashings and the terminology used that you're probably gonna hear. So this type of flashing is called a pipe boot. If you look on your roof, it'll look something like this. Hopefully the shingles are down more. But this is called a pipe boot flashing. This is used to seal off the PVC or the round pipes that are coming out of your roof. So that is a pipe boot or pipe jack. This is a piece of step flashing. This is used to flash anywhere the roof meets a wall or your chimney or something like this. And I'm going to show you on this skylight right here. These pieces right here, it's the same thing as this. This is step flashing. So you can see it goes underneath all these shingles. And what this does is any water that hits here is going, instead of getting underneath the shingle, it's going to hit this metal pan and drip to the next one and so on and so forth. Now, if this is up against like a brick wall or a brick chimney, there's going to be another piece of metal on top of that that's called the counter flashing. And again, I'm using this skylight as an example, but let's pretend for a second that this is a brick chimney and this gasket's not here. So if this is just pure brick, water can still come down and get behind this flashing. That's why we install a counter flashing on top of it that's either cut into the brick or has a bead of sealant here that's also very common to stop water from going down into it. So I just wanted to take a second and just cover the very, very basics. We get a lot of questions and we have a lot of customers who seem to struggle with the terminology. And I don't blame them because it's a lot to have to remember and you're probably only thinking about it a couple times in your life. So I hope this video was really helpful. If you have any questions or comments, please post them below and please like and subscribe for more awesome content. Thanks.